Hello, my name is John Kelly, and this is the Weber Auto YouTube channel. Today, I'm going to show you how to center a universal joint in the driveshaft yoke ears and set the axial play correctly. We have just changed this universal joint, and I have a separate video on how to change universal joints properly without doing any damage. Once we change the U-joint, then we have to make sure that we set the axial play and center the U-joint properly with the snap rings. And there are many different snap ring thicknesses, as I discussed in another YouTube video on universal joint differences. So let me show you how to check the axial play and center a U-joint now. Okay, I've taken the drive shaft that we just replaced this U-joint in, and I've brought it over to a vise with copper jaws, and I'm very carefully just put a light clamping load on the slip joint. I'm not going to damage that if I have copper jaws. So what we need to check is axial play. And as we saw when we were installing the U-joint, there was a whole bunch before we got the snap rings in. But we want to have no more than just a little bit under 2/1000ths of an inch, 1.97 thousandths of an inch. So we'll just call it 2. Axial play in either direction. We do not want to have zero. We do not want it to be preloaded. So we want the joints to be able to move. If it's preloaded, they're stuck real solid, and you're going to have to bend them to make them, or push on them really hard to make them move. Neither of these are preloaded. We may have a zero axial play in the steel yoke ears for that portion of the U-joint. But I've got a dial indicator. I've just got a magnetic dial indicator set up. It's sitting on top of the U-joint bearing in the aluminum ears for our aluminum axle or our drive shaft here. So I've got a dial indicator set up. Let me zoom in so you can see the dial. Okay, so I've pulled down and have it set at zero. The next thing to do is to lift up. So I'm just going to lift up here, and I've got 1, 2, 3, 3.5 thousandths axial play right there. That's too much. That's almost double what we should have. So that means that the 59 thousandths of an inch copper colored snap rings that the kit came with are too thin for the aluminum ears, but it also came with gray and purple snap rings, which were, or gray and pink, the 61 and 63 thousandths of an inch. So it, theoretically or mathematically, if we go an inch or 1/1000th of an inch thicker snap ring on each side, that'll take 2/1000ths out of the axial play. We're at 3.5 minus 2, that should give us 1.5 thousandths right there. So that's what I would do. I would put the gray snap rings that came with the kit in and see where that leaves us. But before we do that, let's measure the axial play on the other end of the U-joint. So let me get that set up. Okay, I've repositioned the drive shaft in the vise by turning it a quarter turn, 90 degrees, and clamped the yoke back in the copper jaws. And now our magnetic dial indicator base can still attach to the yoke, but instead of going to the top of the U-joint bearing cap, because we used to have it on this one, we are going to put it on the end yoke, the flange yoke of the drive shaft. And then as we lift up and down to measure the axial play this way, it should show up over here. So let me zoom in on the dial indicator. I'm going to push down first, zero the dial indicator, and then push up. 1.5 thousandths. So back down. So this one I thought was too tight is actually right in spec, 1.5 thousandths of an inch. So that's I mentioned in several of my episodes here on universal joints that I can't feel, personally, I can't feel clearances that small. I have to measure them. And I suspect many of you are the same way. So before we can put this drive shaft back in the vehicle, I've got to change the snap rings from the copper to the gray here on the side. And then we'll remeasure just to make sure that we're in specification, and then we're good to go back together. So let me go change those real quick. Okay, I've put the gray snap rings in instead of the copper colored ones. I've got the dial indicator set up again to measure the axial play. Push down, I've got the dial indicator zeroed. Now let's lift up and see how much play we have. Whoa. No change. There's zero, there's one, two, three, and a half. Nothing changed. Well, that is interesting. All right, let's go with the pink. They're supposed to be 63 thousandths. I have not actually measured these snap rings that came with this kit, see if they're what they claim to be. All right, as you can see, I've got the pink snap ring installed, which is 63 thousandths. Okay, I'm going to push down with the pink snap rings in, zero, our dial indicator, and we better not have 3.5 thousandths. And lift up, whoa, we have 0.5 thousandths. Good. So, as I said, we do not want zero. We don't have zero. We have a half. We started with 4.5 thousandths with copper snap rings. I installed the gray snap rings that came with the kit. It didn't make any difference, which makes me think I measured something wrong with the copper in. And then I put in the pink, because it comes with four of them, so I have two left over. And the axial play has gone down to 0.5 thousandths. So on this U-joint crossing these bearing caps, I have 0.5 thousandths of axial play. We have two pink snap rings in nice clean grooves that centers the U-joint in the ears of the yoke. On the steel yoke side ears, we have the black 0.57 thousandths snap rings and 1.5 thousandths axial play. Now, if we would have put the 58s in, we would have mathematically, if we're at 1.5 and we increased the thickness by 1/1000th of an inch on each side, we would have been preloaded by 0.5 thousandths of an inch. If we would have forced the copper ones in at 59, then we would be preloaded 2.5 thousandths of an inch. Now, if we would have, interesting thought here, if we would have had the aftermarket kit, let's see, in the aftermarket kit, snap rings were how thick? 54. 54 thousandths of an inch. So the aftermarket U-joint came with 54 thousandths shims, and you can probably guess why. That way they're going to fit no matter what. At 50, we're at 67, 59, nowhere. We are at 57 thousandths of an inch snap rings right now, and we have 1.5 thousandths axial play. If we went clear down to 54 thousandths, which that cheapo kit comes with, that is 3 thousandths of an inch per side. That's an additional 6 thousandths. We would have 7.5 thousandths axial play in this U-joint. That's more than is allowed for class 4 through 8 heavy-duty trucks, the big semi-trucks driving down the road, where their U-joints are gigantic. They have a maximum axial play of 6 thousandths of an inch. So the 54s would have fit. Most technicians or do-it-yourselfers would have thought, oh, great, I'm done, and away we go. And here's the tricky part. It may or may not cause any type of a problem. It really depends on the rotational speed of your driveshaft, which is based on your tire height and your axle gear ratio. It's based on how much runout did you have in your driveshaft to begin with. In other words, what I'm talking about is, will you end up with a vibration after you've changed the U-joint? Can you see now that if all you did was change the U-joint and put in the thinner shims, and now we have the entire U-joint flopping to one side 7/1000ths of an inch, we've just added 7/1000ths of an inch runout to this driveshaft. And if you were already on the edge of too much runout, now you're going to be over the edge with that. Okay, so that is U-joint centering by equal thickness snap rings, and then axial play by changing the snap ring thickness until a reading on a dial indicator indicates that you are within whatever the manufacturer specification is. The Toyota spec that I found was 0.00197, which is almost 2/1000ths of an inch. That is a Spicer 1350 U-joint. This is a Spicer 1330. The only difference is the width, same bearing caps. So it's got to be the same axial play. This, if you look in the General Motors service information, they don't tell you to do anything but replace the U-joint. They don't tell you to measure axial play. The Chrysler book instructions don't say anything about it. Some manufacturers do, some don't. But I've always wondered why, when I change U-joints, are some super stiff, some super loose, some fail sooner than others. Why does the original ones last what seems like forever? And I believe this is why. So this has been a demonstration of checking the axial play and centering a universal joint in a driveshaft.